Myself, Abita, Assistant Professor, School of Commerce at KSR College of Arts and Science for Women, Trichungur. Now, I am going to discuss about the topic of Business Law, Unit 2. Introduction. A valid contract creates legal obligation on both the contracting parties. After the formation of valid contract, the next step is to fulfill the object of the agreement, which requires the performance of respective obligation of the parties. After the performance, the contract is said to be discharged. Contingent contract. A contingent contract is a contract to do or not to do something in some event. Collateral to such contract. Does or does not happen. Insurance contract provides the best example of contingent contract. Features. Dependence on the future event, collateral event, uncertain event. Kinds of contingent contract. The happening of a future uncertain event, the non-happening of an uncertain future event, the future conduct of a living person or event to be deemed impossible, the happening of an event within fixed time, the non-happening of an event within a fixed time, impossible events. Difference between wagering agreement and condition agreement. Wagering agreement, condition agreement. There is a reciprocal promise. In contingent agreement, there is no reciprocal promise. It is a void contract. It is a valid contract. Others are not interested in the contract. Others are interested in the contract. It is contingent in nature. It is may not be wagering in nature. Here, the parties have no interest in the subject matter. Here, the parties may have interest in the subject matter. It is a game. Losing or gaining alone matters. It is not game, now only focus and gaining doesn't matter. Quasi-contract. Quasi-contract is a kind of contract by which one party is bound to pay money in consideration of something done or suffered by other party. These contracts are based on the maximum no man must grow rich out of other person cost. This contract is prevent unjust or enrichment or benefit, that is, no one should grow rich out of another person's loss. Salient features of quasi-contract. A quasi-contract is not a real contract. It is not based upon the offer and acceptance rule. It does not arise from any formal agreement, but it is imposed by law. It is a right which is available not against the entire world, but against particular person only. Difference between contract and quasi-contract. Result from will of the parties expressed with a view to create an obligation. It is an obligation resembling that created by contract. It is an agreement. There is no agreement at all. Here, certain essential elements. Essentials of formation of contract are absent. It is a full-fledged contract and is binding. Resembles a contract, not a full-fledged contract. It is a impaled contract. Performance of contract. A performance of contract takes place where the parties to contract fulfill their obligation arising under the contract within section 37 of the Indian Contract Act lays down the obligation of the parties regarding performance. Discharge by performance. Actual performance. Attempted performance. When both parties perform their promises and there is nothing remained to perform, it's called as actual performance. When the promisor offers to perform his obligation, but promisee refuses to accept the performance, is also known as tender. It is also called as attempted performance. Essentials requisites of a valid tender. It must be unconditional. It must be made a proper time and place. It should be respect of the whole obligation. It must provide us reasonable opportunities. It may not be one of the joint promises. By whom contracts must be performed? Promisor, agent, legal perspectives, third parties, joint promises. Name of the person who can demand performance of contract. It is only the promisee who can demand performance of the promise under a contract. It makes no difference whether the promise is for the benefit of the promisee or any other person. The legal respective can enforce performance of the contract upon the other party or their legal respectiveness. Performance of joint promisee. Devolution means passing over or transform from one person to another. When two or more persons have made joint promise, they are known as joint promises. Time and place of performance, where no application is to be made and no time is specified, where time is specified and no application is to be made. Application for performance on a certain day and place. Application by promiser to promisee to appoint place. Performance in manner or at time prescribed or sanctioned by promisee. Definition of reciprocal promise. Under section 2F, promises which form the consideration or part of consideration for each other are called reciprocal promise. In the case of bilateral contract, each party is not only the promiser but the promisee also, since one of them gives a promise in exchange of other. A promisee against a promise is good consideration. Types of reciprocal promise: mutual and dependent, mutual concurrent. Consequence, where a party prevents performance under section 53. Rules regarding performance of reciprocal promise: order to performance, effect of one party prevent another to do things legal and other things illegal. Effect of default as to promise to be performed is. Discharge of contract. When the obligation created by contract comes to the end, the contract is said to be discharged. Remedies. When a contract is broken by party, there are several courses of action which to other party may pursue. These remedies include: state the rules regarding measures of damages. The rules of regarding measures of damages are as follows. The damages are awarded by way of compensation and not for the purpose of punishing the guilty party of the breach. The injured party is to be placed in the same position so far as money can do, as if the contract has been performed. The aggrieved party can recover by way of compensation only the actual loss suffered by him, arising naturally in the usual course of things from the breach itself. Thank you.